Is your bathroom drain stopper not working in your sink? Let me show you how to fix that real quick and simply. And this is a little bit different than the newer style ones that don't have a lift rod. They just have something that you kind of depress the drain. You actually depress it. You might click it or something like that, and it'll stop it and prevent it from draining. And then you have to unclick it to drain again. I have a video up in the card to the right up there if you want to check out if you have questions about that particular style. But today I'll be working on one that is an older style that has this little lift rod that should be pulling up and down that drain stopper. So let's jump into it. So here we are underneath the sink. And let me just show you a little, do a little anatomy lesson of kind of what's going on here. If you can see up there going through that hole, that is your lift rod. So that goes to that little chrome handle that you pull up on the top of the sink. And right there, that screw, that is called the clevis screw, which attaches the lift rod up there to this clevis rod with all these holes down here. And the holes down here align with this lift rod, or excuse me, the pivot rod. That pivot rod is what actually stops the drain and opens the drain. So if you can imagine, when this clevis rod is pulled up or down, this lift rod or this pivot rod opens and closes the drain when that lift rod all the way up there is pulled or pushed down, therefore moving this pivot rod up or down. So it's a pretty simple mechanism, and as you can pretty readily see, the problem is these two are not attached. The pivot rod is not attached to the clevis rod, and what attaches it, and then you can kind of see here that I've discovered this spring that holds the clevis rod to the pivot rod has fallen off. So it's a pretty simple thing to put this back together. Let's show you how to do that. So what I want to do first is put that clevis or that spring clip around the clevis bar and the hole that we're going to use. And then we're just going to finagle that pivot bar through there. And what should happen is that spring clip should hold this all in place as this clevis bar moves up and down. Now sometimes this might be, the spring bar might be a little loose, so what you can do is just widen this with your hands. It's not, they're not too tough, so if you just widen it a little bit with your hands, that will help make it even more secure on that pivot bar. So let's try that. So again, pull it through, line it up with the clevis bar, and then kind of push that pivot bar through. And as you can see, it's a lot more tight of a push on like that. So that makes me feel a little bit better now, knowing that this spring bar is tighter, the spring clamp is tighter on that pivot bar. So now with that in place, now we can test out our work by moving it up and down. So I'm going to pull on the pivot bar above top of the sink, and that's what we want to see. And do this a couple times just to make sure that spring clamp doesn't start falling off and get you into the same position you were last time. More than likely, this spring bar will just need to be, you know, widened again to help it stay in place, because sometimes over time it can, you know, get smaller or it might break or whatnot. So this is usually the culprit and why your drain stop is not working when you pull on that lift bar on the top. So yeah, so if that lift rod, you're not having any success with it engaging the drain and disengaging it, check on this spring clip right here. That spring clip is likely the culprit. Now lastly, if it's not that spring clip right there that's the issue, if that's still engaged when you move the drain stop up and down and that lift rod, and the next place to check is that screw. Because if that screw up there, that clevis screw which attaches the lift rod to the clevis bar, if that isn't attached, then obviously when you pull up and down on that lift rod, and of course it's not going to engage this lower half of the drain mechanism. So check there, and also check your spring clip right there, and that should get you back in business. So I'll show you a top hand view to see that this is now working. Now I just want to make one more note. You notice that I used the second from the bottom hole within the clevis bar to put my spring clip and
pivot reading rod through. Now that honestly was just kind of a lucky gamble. Sometimes you might need to try out maybe this hole on the clevis bar or that hole just to see what actually works with your lifting mechanism. There's a reason why there's multiple holes here, because it needs to accommodate the length of piping and to the drain and all that sorts of differences that can come from your specific and unique sink and draining system. That's why it's made this way, so it can be tailored to your specific needs. So feel free, try it out in one hole of the clevis bar, move up that lift rod, and if it doesn't work, if it doesn't completely seal and completely drain the water out, try again, try a different hole. And that's another important test too, is after, you know, you've made sure that it lifts up and down without issue, actually put water in this system and see if that drain holds. And if it's not working, try a different hole. So that's the thing is, with this, there's no sometimes magical method in knowing exactly what that might be, but trial and error sometimes is a good way to go.
And that's what we want to see. If you have any questions, put them in the comment section below. This video was helpful. Please give it a like and subscribe. Share this with other people. And if you have any tips or tricks, please share them with us below. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.